Hello everyone. Welcome to the channel. In this video we will see about setting multiple SSID in a single Cyratec modem. As you can see, I have connected the modem to the laptop through LAN cable. Now there in the Wi-Fi tab you can see a single Wi-Fi name. To set up multiple IDs in a single device, open the browser and enter the default gateway of the router, which is mostly 192.168.1.1. And once you enter, the login page opens. Enter the login username and password and click the login button. Once logged in, you can see the device information. Click Network. Go to WLAN and you can see the default SSID in there. Click All and Advanced and select different SSID isolation. Change it from off to on. Enable the AP1. And click Apply Changes. You can change the name also, from FTTH to anything you wish to have. Now, when you check the Wi-Fi tab, an additional SSID will be there. To secure the SSID with a password, go to OLAN Security and select SSID type. You'll find the new SSID there. Select the encryption type you need and apply. Coming back to Advanced. If you click the Show button, you can see the devices connected to the new SSID. Further, you can also enable two more SSID here, bringing the total count of the SSID to 4. I've enabled a third one. The laptop interface is little slow to recognize it. Hence, I've to refresh it a multiple times. But, if you see in the security tab, you can find the third SSID which I've enabled. So, what exactly is the purpose of setting up multiple SSID? I too had a doubt on this. My take on it is that you can set the second SSID as a guest network. So, when someone comes to your house, you can turn it on and then off it. So that you don't have to change the Wi-Fi password every time. Else, if you are gaming or streaming, you can isolate the device with a different SSID. You can also enable QoS for gaming in a SSID. Or limit the speeds in a SSID with QoS. There are multiple benefits, which are user dependent. So, what is said above is the procedure to set up multiple SSID in Cyratec modems on any other types which share the same firmware. If you like the video, kindly subscribe. And also, drop your valuable comments in the comments section below.